up against the man mountain in Jared Redden. And the umpire, David Sobrach, holds the ball aloft. We're underway in the second semi-final. A grand final berth on the line. There's no decisive hit out. Hanneth just tried to step around his opponent. Stacks on the mill. And we'll have a secondary ball up for the Tigers in season 2021.
Under-18 premiership player with the Bloods.
That seems so long ago. We called that one at the Bay on a Friday night.
2014 it was, as we see yet another ball up. Hanneth slaps it down towards half forward. Chance for the Bays as they push forward through Bailey. Hooks this one back inside 50. Pink knocked it down cleverly to Hosey. First goal of the semi-final to the Bays. Spent time with Melbourne and Port Adelaide in the AFL, back his original club as Goldsworthy. Good sport at the last second on land. Comes the way of Ferns. Now Poole measures the kick inside 50. Beautiful pass from Poole from just inside 50. Starts it right, brings it back beautifully. Oh. Wonderful goal from Daniel Menzel. The Eagles get there first. The scores are level. 11 gone.
Star your two. Eagles.
SANFL Digital Pass Player of the Year in 2021. Nice kick, McBean. Knocked away from him.
Free kick.
Ground level. Free kick. He's going to come back here. The Eagles defenders aren't happy, but McBean is going to be the recipient, and so he can line up for his first tonight and in the SANFL final series. No mistake from McBean. 14 and a half gone first term. The Tigers by 6 points. Jungfer. No one can take possession. Hurried kick by Lonigan. Back towards half forward. Durden was met strongly. Went to ground. Hayes comes through. Knocked it out. Nice little give. The Eagles inside 50. Wonderful kick. Wonderful vision. Commodore Gianni over the top. And Troy Menzel finishes with the goals and levels the score. And Jack Hayes does it very, very nice. Having a fantastic year. Gets it moving inside 50. Kobe Much says thank you very much. And he will go back. And he's dobbed that one. So Much with his first. The Eagles skip out to a 7-point lead. 23 and a half gone first quarter.
This first term we've travelled 24 and a half minutes as the Eagles will again go forward. It's through Putney, inside 50, go Woodville West Torrens. A bounce favours for Stengel. He gets around his opponent, kicks towards goal, and kicks another one for the Eagles. Stengel with his first, a fantastic finish, John Nankerville.
And the Bays come out here towards halfback. Pink's got two to beat, and he's outpointed by Rowland, who chips short to Cheetus. Goes long inside 50, looking for the lead, knocked away. Where are the crummers? Commodore Gianni was good to Lonigan. Lonigan snaps, and Lonigan goals for the Eagles. The Eagles out to a 19-point lead. 27 and a half gone first term.
The former Adelaide Crow inside 50 go the Eagles. Backing back there courageously was Virgin, but it spills fortuitously to Troy Mendel. In fact, brother Dan, he pops it up looking for Much. Good work, though, from the Tigers' defence. And the relieve momentarily there for the player in land. The kick falls to the favour of the big fella, or the youngster rather, in Beacon, and he's kicked it! From St. Albans as the kick out of defensive 50 is going to come back in for the Tigers. Well done there by Allen, found a teammate in Snoop, the boy from Cabra College. Run 5 or so metres, kick it inside 50, McBean flies, crumbing there, Reynolds couldn't take it cleanly. Was he dispossessed in the art of the tackle? The umpire said you were hung on to. So Luke Reynolds, the man from Taparoo. 30 out, straight in front, kicks the goal. The Tigers get their third. Reynolds gets his first.
Little give to Turner to Curran. Glenelg working nicely. This is good. Chandler just into the action, gave to Motlop, and he goes short. And the mark is taken by Hosey. Hooks it back. I don't know if it was good vision or if he shanked the kick. Reynolds was coming out on the lead. Couldn't take it. Commodore Gianni found space. Sinor couldn't quite take it. Allen off a step from 48, and Allen finishes with a goal to Glenelg. They've got the last two. It's big Redden against Hanneth in the ruck. Slaps it down towards 50 at the back. Knight hurrying it through inside 50, and Dan Menzel slides out and takes a very nice mark, and he can line up to kick the steadier for the Eagles. Does it very nicely. He's got two for the evening, Menzel. And the Eagles out to a 21-point lead. Time on, 20 minutes gone, second term.
Plays played some footy with the Melbourne Demons, who are off to their first grand final since 2000. The next level was the kick down the line. Good spoil at the back there from the Eagles player in much, but it spills out now fortuitously for the Tigers. It's in the hands there of Bailey, who'll go inside 50, and nothing the Eagles defence could do. Separation from McBean is marked directly in front, 40 metres out. I got my local Victorian clubs mixed up earlier in the call when I said he was from St Albans. He was originally from St Bernard's, as McBean kicks towards goal. He's got his second, and the Tigers have got their fifth.
In the end, taken by Chandler, too slow, young man, run down by Sinor, and Joe Sinor takes the free for the Eagles. Comes out towards the centre wing position, finds Beacon, nice little jive around McBean, pops it up,
great
running
kick.
Back, great vision, and running in and taking a very fine mark is Matty Goldsworthy, 35 out, straight in front. Goldsworthy lines up for his first goal, first of the second half. He's nailed it. Goldsworthy gets the scoring underway.
To follow up his second effort off the non-preferred left, kicks around the corner. It's a well-weighted kick, and he finds a teammate in Goldsworthy. He blazes away towards the goal square. In the box position, Menzel. Quick transition footy from the Eagles, and Daniel Menzel's marked at the top of the square. And a very good start to this third term, John Nankerville, for the reigning premiers.
Who are coming out full of running as Menzels begins his run in for goal.
The boy from Golden Grove keeps it low, keeps it straight. There's his third, and the Eagles are kicking away. Spots up Virgin, who takes the mark under some pressure and then releases from defensive 50. McBean gets front position and takes a nice mark from the outstretched fingertips. The kick inboard's a dangerous one, but he finds a teammate there in Darcy Bailey. He'll play on quickly. He'll spot up the player there in Billy Martini. In fact, a goal for the Tigers coming up, and I reckon that is the Glenelg player in Allen, and a goal to the Tigers. A great finish there from the former West Coast player. Good work in there from Stengel, stood in the tackle, somehow spills out. The voice comes to Putney off the non-preferred left. He'll kick to the top of the square. Menzel in a wrestle, and Menzel with a slips catch. Troy Menzel in the right forward pocket took a diving mark, Stevie J style. So Menzel opens up the angle, kicks around the corner, and kicks a goal. The Eagles get their 10th. Menzel gets his second.
Snoop now kicks into the middle of the ground. Lance went onto it. Good run from him over the top to Allen. He's kicked two tonight. He won't go for goal. He goes short. Hosey. Oh, that won't score. High ball. McBean comes from the side there. Bailey. Bailey off the ground. And Bailey's got the goal for the Bays. Boy, they needed it. And Darcy Bailey provides it for them.
For the Tigers, we're about to tick into the 28-minute mark. Motlop's chipping ball set up easily for the spoil from Jungfer. Handball over the top now from the Eagles. Paul gives it to Roland. Inboard now to Sinor. Perhaps another last chance for the Eagles. Sinor's kick chopped off. Crump beautifully by Menzel. In fact, it was Stengel, apologies. And he kicks a goal. Opportunist goal for the Eagles. And when you give the ball inside 50 to Stengel, he will make you pay, John. Snaps his second goal. Of Jack Hanneth, the boy from Angaston. The middle of Adelaide Oval. Kick long inside 50. The Tigers need a mark, and they've got it. McBean with a fly. A strong contested pack mark from the Ken Farmer medalist. From directly in front, 40 metres out. McBean kicks the first goal of the final term, and the Tigers' comeback may be starting.
Lumbered after it, knocked it back to Thompson. Handled into open space. Snoop was good to Turner. Here come the Tigers again. Turner searching down there for Motlop. Crumbed by Bailey. Back-to-back goals to start the final quarter for the Tigers. Their fans are up and about. They trail by 17 points. He goes searching towards half forward over the head of the intended target. Pink there with Jafrida. Red in the unlikely Crummer. Got it to Cameron. He tries to knock it to Cheetahs. Goes past him. Motlop. Little kick inside 50. Turner waited. Had to attack it. In the end, he did it quite nicely, though. And he rolls on through. A hat-trick of goals to start the final quarter for the Bays.
Push through as a big-bodied midfielder. This is the way with modern footy. McBean flies on centre wing, out of sight. His hand pass just through the fingertips there of a teammate. A turnover from the Tigers. Coming inside 50, go the Eagles. Sitting back there, Newman. Courageously back, but coming now, Stengel. Picks it up, goes one way, then the other. Gets around his opponent, looks for Menzel, Troy Variety. He goes to ground in a tackle. Curran did well. Handball comes out towards Dan Menzel. Off the non-preferred left, Daniel Menzel. He's kicked it! A great snap around the corner, a fourth for Dan Menzel.
Virgin up to Bailey, to Pink. Pink now inside 50. Oh, Hosey was up, didn't quite pull it down. He was hung on to, though, when he hit the ground. He dropped the mark, but was grabbed without the footy. People booing left, right and centre.
And 25,
and 25 wasn't thrown back to him. So Hosey, with the benefit of 25, will come from about 45 out to about 20 out. He's not in any great hurry to get down there. He's going to come off the Jeff Thompson long run in the context of this contest to put it back to 11 points. He's kicked it very nicely, Hosey. He gets his second for the evening, and the Bays are hanging in there.
It's Lan. It's been very impressive tonight and this year. The kick was a good one. Out into some space for stretch to mark. Hits the ground running. Plays on quickly. Comes in board. Looks for the teammate in Chandler. Off the left boot. The Tigers go bang! And Chandler kicks a goal, and it's back to 5 points.
The young man from Cowra, Rutherglen. McCarthy, who's been good for the Bays, takes the mark, goes short to Turner, who's been close, or certainly one of Glenelg's best. He sees Lant in the middle of the ground. Glenelg going backwards and sideways to try and go forward. Lant evades Stengel. Long kick inside 50. McBean was sort of restricted, but Reynolds in from the side has taken the mark. McBean may have been hung on to, but Reynolds dipped in from the side, and the veterans got it, and he can line up at the 19-minute mark of this fourth quarter for what would be
a pack situation.
Luke Reynolds,
wow,
has put the Bays in front by a point. Wow indeed, Phil Aspinall, his second. Luke Reynolds. Glenelg have now kicked 6 goals to 1. To keep things moving, though, into time on now in this last term. Menzels kicks a very nice one. It finds Lonergan. Here go the Eagles. Lonergan, high kick. Stengel's there. Dan Menzel is there. Stengel tries to go off the ground. Martini tackled, lost it. Stengel pounces. Thank you very much, says Tyson. And he puts the Eagles back in front by 4 points with his third goal. Tyson Stengel
just pickpocketed his opponent. Unfortunately, Martini just couldn't be clean, got possession, then went to ground in the tackle, and a great forward pressure effort from the Eagles. Composed footy, and his kick, though, it's been intercepted. Nice turnover from the Tigers, and Curran, the captain of Glenelg, he'll bang it back inside 50 again. They need him up. Siren! The Eagles have won! Woodville West Torrens victors. They're through to the 2021 Grand Final. And what a thrilling second semi-final. And the final scores, the Eagles 13-8-86. Defeat Glenelg 13-4-82. A 4-point victory to the Eagles. And they're off to the big dance, John Nankerville, for the second year in a row.
Oh, but what a thrilling finish. I mean, it'll give you a burst of the song, but a great win by the Eagles. Stand aside, turn us loose and watch the banners fly.